Hey, it's Joe Crump. This question is for Murat Tekpilek from Rochester, New York. Murat says, hi, Joe. Will your autopilot email system work even though Craigslist scrapers no longer work? And by this question, I'm not exactly sure what he's saying. He says, is he saying, you know, do my scrapers not work, or is it that scrapers don't work with Craigslist and that's what he's heard, that nobody's able to accomplish that, which is, I think, is what he's saying here. And that's true. It's very difficult to make a scraper work with Craigslist because of the way they set their system up. But we have a way to scrape that system, and it's consistent and it works. And every time Craigslist makes a change to their site, we have to make some modifications on our end as well. And sometimes it creates a little bit of downtime, a day or two or whatever, will drop down while we have to rebuild the scrapers so that it continues to work with that system. But so far we've not had a problem, and we've been doing it for several years now, and it seems to be working fine. Every once in a while we have a few head scratchers that we have to deal with, and we understand why Craigslist is trying to do that. They're trying to keep spam from happening on their site, and we agree with that. We don't spam. The only thing that we're doing with the automarketer is making offers to people who have properties for sale. So they say, I'm looking for a buyer for my property, and we're saying, I'm a buyer, I want to buy your property. So we're doing exactly what Craigslist is designed to do. We're responding specifically to the specific ad that they've got. We're not trying to go out there and spam other people. So Craigslist isn't upset with us. What they're trying to do is to keep other spammers from getting through their process. At least I don't think they're upset with us. They've never contacted us. So it is possible for us to scrape. We are scraping it regularly. We do limit how much you can do. We say up to 5 cities for each automarketer account. So you can go into 5 different areas if you choose to do that. And we ask you not to scrape areas that you don't need, because it just puts an extra load on our system, and we don't want that to happen. So we want to keep the system up and running and fluid and going all the time. Now, the reason I built this system in the first place was for my own use, for my own business, so that we could do the marketing. And after using it for a while, I decided, you know, this really works well. I can't possibly do all the business that's out there. I can't possibly do every city and town and state that's in Craigslist or in eBay Classifieds or in, all the other sites that we scrape. So why don't I make this available as a piece of software, as a subscription base to the other people that I teach, and make some money doing that as well. So that's what we do. Now, I know, as a software designer and owner and working with coders, that there are problems sometimes with software, especially when you're set up to react to another site. If you're trying to pull data, and there's a lot of data aggregator sites out there, like if you look at Travelocity or any of the sites that are aggregating information, where you're foreclosure, sites or whatever. They're all pulling information from a lot of different sites. They're scraping different sites, pulling it together, aggregating it, and making it available for that person. That's essentially what we're doing with the automarketer, by pulling together the ads of people that are selling their houses and are renting their houses out from around the internet. And by doing that, we have to be reactive to the changes that they make to those sites. They don't give us warning in advance that they're going to make changes. They don't feel responsible to us. So when those things happen, we have to go in and we have to make tweaks to that to happen. And that takes time, and sometimes the system doesn't work during that time that it's down, the day or 2 or 3 days that happens. Now, I know as a software designer that I expect those things to happen, and it's not a big surprise to me. But sometimes when you're paying $199 a month for an automarketer, you think that it should be up and running every single day and every single second of that day. I can tell you right now that that's not going to happen. It's not going to be up every single second of every single day. Even though we have a very high percentage of uptime, there is times that it drops down. And I know that can get frustrating for people sometimes. You have to make the decision, do I want to use this tool? That nobody else has a tool like this, by the way. And I got a question a time or two on my videos, how do you scrape these things? And we have a very smart coder with a PhD who understands how to do this stuff, and we build these systems so that it works. We pay a lot of money to make these systems work. it's unlikely that you'll be able to accomplish the same thing, that you'll be able to build the same type of system without spending the hundreds of thousands of dollars that I've spent on this system to make it work and to keep it and maintain it. And so what I'm saying to you is that there may be some downtime as you use this thing, but it's the same downtime that I'm having, but it's still profitable even if there is some downtime. Expect the downtime because that's the nature of the beast. On the other hand, we're going to do our very best to get it up and running for you. The expense and the cost and the effort to make it happen, that's on our shoulders, not on yours. And the cost of $199 a month is very cheap. And we're actually considering raising the price because we keep adding new features to it. So we may be raising the price here before long. But for right now, at this cost, plus getting the websites and the training and some other things that you get in this system, it's a phenomenal value for your money. Anyway, I hope that answers the question. We can make this work, and we don't have to worry about Craigslist and scrapers and things like that. We know what we're doing. Okay, thanks.